And let's start with the first question. Which of the following CSS properties control the size of an element's content? Padding and margin, border and padding, height and width, height and padding. So height and width should be the right answer. Yep. Which of the following is not part of the CSS box model? If you remember, we have three parts of the box model. We have padding, we have borders, and we have margin at the end. So div is the intruder here. Which property should fill the blank in the following CSS called snippet? And this is the value for the borders. So border, yep. In the sample code below, the element with ID 1 is directly above the element with ID 2 in the HTML document. How much space is between the border of element 1 and the border of element 2? Let's see. So we have 20 margins on all sides for the element 1. For the element 2, we have 30 margins on all four sides. But because we need to check how much space is between the borders of element 1 and the border of element 2, so we will calculate only the vertical margins. And if you remember, vertical margins do not stack. So we will have 20 and 30 for this one. And the bigger margins takes the place. So 30 pixels should be the right answer. Yep. And they also said the vertical margins of these two elements will not add together, but will collapse to the larger value of the two. So the larger value is 30 pixels. Which of the following properties control how to display content that is too large for its container? Let me see. So overflow, right? Okay. What is the name of the space between the content container and the border? Width, margin, padding, and height. And between the content area and the borders, we have padding. Margins come outside. They come after the borders. Okay. What is the total height of a box element with the CSS properties below? Let's see. So border 1 pixel on all sides, padding 10 pixels on all sides, and height 125. So let me see, border, we are calculating the height. Okay, so we have top and bottom of 1 pixel, that is 2 pixels. We have top and bottom padding of 10, that is 20. So in total, for now, we have 22 pixels. And we have a height of 125 pixels. And because we don't have a box sizing property set, then by default, the total height will be affected by the borders and padding. So the right answer is 22 plus 125, 147. Okay, it is correct, of course. Which of the following will set the vertical padding to 20 pixels and horizontal padding to 40 pixels? So 20 top and bottom and 40 right and left. This should be the right answer. Okay, it is. Which of the following will set the right padding to 10 pixels, bottom padding to 15 pixels, left to 12 pixels, and top to 25 pixels? Okay, let's see. Top is 25, right here we have 25, right is 10 pixels, okay, this is 10, then bottom is 15, and left is, so this one should be the right answer. Yep, it is. Which of the following will set the top and bottom margins to 15 pixels and left and right margins to 30 pixels? So top and bottom is 15 pixels and left and right is 30 pixels. This one, it is the right answer, of course. Now, which of the following accurately explains the CSS code below? We have a div element with the class of headline. We have a width set to 300 pixels, and then we have a margin 0 auto, which means we are centering this element horizontally. The div headline elements will have a width of 300 pixels and no margins. This is false. The div headline elements will have a width of 300 pixels and be horizontally and vertically centered on the page. Okay, let's see the next one. The div headline elements will have a width of 300 pixels, a vertical margin of 0, and will be horizontally centered within their parent container. And this one should be the right answer, but let me check the last one. The div headline elements will have a width of 300 pixels, horizontal margin of 0, and will be vertically centered within their parent container. This is false, so this one should be the right answer. It is. And let's see the last question. What is the name of the space between the border of one element and the next element? And like I said, margins come after the borders, so the right answer should be margin. And this is also correct, of course. We scored maximum 100% result. And now let's continue to the next section. And in the next section, we will do the article type of section, and it is called the box model in DevTools.